Hi guys, follow me on Instagram to never ever miss any of my crazy updates.
Hi guys and welcome to another vlog. I'm riding this, the Honda CB1100 RS, a motorcycle which is retro yet looks absolutely stunning. Just look at the forks on this motorcycle. Now obviously there are two variants, there's the EX and there's the RS. The RS gets alloy wheels instead of spoke wheels, it gets golden colored rims, and look at the attention on the headlight as well. LED indicators, and the finishing on the engine is just mind-boggling. So you get a single piece seat, this is the place to hold on to. And from the rear, I mean, they have retained the retro charm pretty well. In fact, the tires, although very wide on this motorcycle, gel well with the retro look of this machine. So as you can see, this rear tire, it's from Dunlop. Meanwhile, the exhaust it's not something which will really attract attention. However, what will is the engine. I mean, look at the attention to detail over here. Now, it's a four cylinder unit and it looks beautiful. It's an inline four motor and my goodness, what a design. Lovely. So you can see it gets dual exhaust and it gets Showa So springs or rear suspension. It doesn't get a monoshock to keep the authentic charm intact, and the tank is nice and big. In fact, it can accommodate almost 17 liters. Nice switchgear, you get a hazard light switch over here. This is the starter button, this is the engine kill switch. Over here we have the low beam and the high beam. This is the horn and this is the indicator switch. Adjustable levers both for the clutch as well as the brake. Round mirrors, nice easy to read instrument cluster. In fact, let me turn on the cluster right away for you guys. So here we go. As you can see, it does a full swipe. In the center we get a digital display which has a gear position indicator, also a clock, fuel meter, trip meters, and I mean, I love the analog units over here. They're really nice. Showa dual bending valve forks up front, adjustable obviously, chrome in good measure, and the seat height is on the lower side, but every sort of rider will be comfortable on this motorcycle. The seat height isn't too much, it's not too less either. CB1100 written over here, and it also gets a main stand. The other side, a main stand as well. So let's get onto the motorcycle, and right away let me tell you that the riding posture is slightly leaned in. Now this is the RS version, the EX version isn't that committed as such, but still a very comfortable motorcycle, definitely. Starts very smoothly. So anyways, as you can see, the motorcycle is nice and comfortable. The pegs are slightly rear set, in fact more of center set pegs. There's the city with wide wheels. Doesn't it look awesome? Now that is obviously a VTEC, no diesel over here in Malaysia. And that is the Honda CB500X. That's the gold wing. The cops are ready to escort us, so I think we're all set to go. Here we go. So guys, I'm riding this motorcycle right now, the CB1100 RS, and as I get under the throttle, let me tell you, this engine is butter smooth. So it is powered by a motor which produces almost 90 horsepower, good refinement, extremely refined actually. It's an air-cooled engine and still it is so refined, and it's a four-cylinder unit, but the way it pulls is just amazing. In fact, there was a lot of attention to detail on the engine itself. What Honda did was, believe you me, they have actually worked on, you know, bringing out the sound of this motor at lower revs, and it has this typical cruiser, or rather the original CB sound, which is so good. There's so much punch from this motor. I mean, get onto the gas and it absolutely takes off some amount of buzzing and vibes on the seat right now. But what excellent performance. This is an engine which loves to pull good mid-range. In fact, the low end mid-range is what really excites on this motorcycle. It redlines at around 9000 rpm, slightly lower than 9000 rpm, but the performance is really punchy. It doesn't feel stiff as such, but around the corners it doesn't inspire much confidence, although the ride quality is good. There's some amount of vibes on the tank as well, but overall this is a motorcycle which, I mean, blends the retro charm beautifully well. It's really punchy, really fun, and definitely looks the part as well. So getting into next gear, it is a 6-speed unit, 6-speed gearbox. It's written 6-speed over here inside the tachometer, and most interesting thing is that this console will also tell you what is the fuel economy on offer. Right now it's returning somewhere around 18 kilometers per liter. As I get onto the gas, let me tell you, it pulls so cleanly and nicely. I mean, you're riding a retro motorcycle with an amazing engine because there's so much punch from this motor. It really pulls all the way. The brakes also offer sure footed stopping power. Now let me tell you an interesting story. So everyone has been going into, you know, making cafe racers and making retro motorcycles because retro seems to be the latest fad. However, Honda didn't have one, so they decided, let's bring out the CB, okay, somewhere around the 1100. So it's 1100 because of the displacement. So then Honda made one motorcycle, and that was around in 2013. It was decent, but it wasn't that great. And in order to make that motorcycle also, Honda didn't just be like, okay, let's make a motorcycle. What they did is they sent their engineers to Motegi, where their museum is, to study the old CBs, like the CB400 and the likes, to understand how exactly this new one needs to look and behave like. And in 2017, they launched the Euro 4 version of this motorcycle, which was heavily revised to variants EX as well as RS. The RS is a bit more, sporty, obviously, because it has the RS tag. And in any get onto the throttle, it absolutely pulls so strongly. It's an amazing motorcycle in terms of performance. Here we go. Just see how it is so refined, so punchy, so much fun to ride. I want Honda to launch this in India. Trust me, this is a motorcycle which makes other classic motorcycles look like, oh, outdated. And yeah, retro doesn't have to be outdated. This is what Honda is trying to prove over here. And they're doing a great job, because honestly, this motorcycle might be retro, but it doesn't ride like retro. I mean, it rides like retro, but it still has a charm of modernness. It has the charm of punchy performance, great handling for a motorcycle of this kind, and obviously superb brakes as well. If and when launched in India, it's going to cost at least rupees 20 lakhs or so. But this motor, this inline 4, is such a beauty. The riding posture is slightly leaned in, but honestly, this is not a motorcycle you're going to go touring with. And the foot area might be slightly cramped as well for a person of my height, but this is an amazing motorcycle. Well, here's the funny thing. This motorcycle even has stop and power, really pulls strongly. It also gets a slipper clutch. So Honda's not left anything in terms of technology. It really rides so well and also looks like $1 million. I love the paint scheme on the Africa Twin. Okay, don't digress. Focus. I mean, it's like a complete fest here with Honda motorcycles. Right now riding in second gear. Just slight twist of the throttle, and my goodness, this motorcycle pulls strongly. And it's quite comfortable over these sort of rumblers. Not really rumblers, but whatever. Okay, now I'm going to do an experiment. I put the motorcycle in 6th gear and we are riding at around 90 kilometers per hour, 2,500 RPM. Open the throttle and yeah, it pulls immediately. It doesn't make a racket as such immediately, but okay, the traffic has been stopped again. So it doesn't make a racket immediately, and it's around 4,500 RPM when the madness starts to hit up. The massive mid-range comes into play, and then it simply takes off. This makes me highlight how this motorcycle has dual characteristics. Like, it's absolutely smooth at 100 kilometers per hour in top gear, but that's around 3,000 RPM. And as you open the throttle, it will pull again smoothly. However, the madness will only happen once you get past the mid-range or get to around 4,000-5,000 RPM, and where it absolutely pulls, like it really pulls. It's not a motorcycle which will pin you back into the seat. There's no seat actually in it will like kind of throw you behind, sort of, but it's more of a motorcycle which feels so reassuring and fun to ride. I mean, it has the performance, it has the thrust, downshifting here, fourth, third, second, here we go, and there it absolutely erupts. I mean, wow, what performance, smoothness. Honda has really made an amazing motorcycle. What an engine, what a motor, what a motorcycle. So much fun to ride. Just accelerates with so much. Oh my god, I have, like, I'm lost with words, because this is how much I love this motorcycle. Blending retro charm with modern appeal and amazing performance. That's something rarely done, which Honda has definitely done. It took them some time, it took them a lot of studying, a lot of engineering, but hey, the end result is just fab. Oh my god, I can keep doing this all day long. Surging ahead, falling back, surging ahead, falling back, surging ahead. And yeah, there is a fire blade right in my rear view mirror right now. So my eyes are kind of like hovering onto the rear view mirror because I'm kind of distracted with it. I mean, who wouldn't be? This never gets old, does it? Nope, not at all.